This is a tutorial video offered by the University of Arkansas at Little Rock's Department of Rhetoric and Writing in a series about how to compose a digital writing portfolio. Hello, my name is Josh. I'm a lecturer for our composition program, and this is a tutorial on how to make a digital writing portfolio using Google Sites. While many free platforms exist for creating digital portfolios, in the UALR composition program, we recommend using Google Sites because it is a feature of your official UALR email and has security features to make sure your writing is viewable only to the UALR community. Let's begin. First, open up a web browser to make sure that your web browser works correctly with Google Sites. I recommend using Google Chrome or Firefox. Next, open up your UALR email. Now, click on the Apps icon in the upper right-hand corner of your screen right next to your name. Now click on Sites. Click Create in the left-hand corner of your screen. Select Blank Template. Now name your site. Now click Create again. Now that you have a space to house your digital portfolio, it's time to start adding content. In the upper right-hand corner of your screen, click on Edit Page. Now you can add content. You'll notice at the top of the screen it looks very similar to a Microsoft Office Word document. You can change the text, you can bold, you can underline, you can insert images, YouTube, you can format, you can insert tables, you can select layouts. When you're done, click Save. Now it's time to start adding pages. Click on New Page next to Edit Page. It's time to name your page. I'm going to name my page About Me. Select Web Page as the template and select the location, put at the top level. That determines where your page will be located in your navigation. Click on Create. Now click Save. Now I'm going to add some more pages. Okay, now I've created several web pages, including About Me, Major Writing Projects, Minor Writing Assignments, Reflection of My Learning, and this is a link that was already on there called Sitemap. I'm going to show you how to change your navigation. Under More, there's a lot of different options, including Page Actions, which include Page Settings, Delete Page. I'm going to click on Edit Site Layout. Now I can click on my header. I can choose which elements of the page are showing, including horizontal navigation, which I can hide or add. I'm going to go to the sidebar and click on Navigation. I'm going to uncheck Include a Link to Sitemap, and I'm going to uncheck Automatically Organize My Navigation. Nothing's there right now, so if I click OK, it hides everything. I click on it again, and I'm going to start adding my pages back, starting with About Me. Now I'm going to add the rest of them back. Okay, once you have all of your pages added to your navigation, you can move them around. So for example, I'm going to select Home. I can delete it from the navigation. Note, that doesn't delete the page, just deletes it from the navigation. I can move it up. Then I'm going to take the reflection of my learning and also move that up. I'm going to click OK, then close. Now I have a new navigation for my web page, for my website. Click on More. I'll show you one last thing, Manage Site. Under Manage Site, you can do many things. You can look at all of your pages, not just the ones that are in your navigation. Under General, you can rename your site, you can copy your site, you can delete your site. Under Sharing and Permissions, This determines who can actually look at your website and if people can edit it. In order to ensure the accountability of your composition education in response to the national learning outcomes, we ask that you set your site to be viewable to all members of the UALR community who have the link. To do so, here where it says UALR, click Change, People at UALR with the link, and then click Can Edit and switch it to Can View, and then Save. If you would like to invite anybody outside of the UALR community to look at your site, you can enter their email address under Invite People. Just make sure that you click on Can Edit and change it to Can View. You should be the only one who is an author of your site and the only one who is changing the content. The last area I'm going to show you is Themes, Colors, and Fonts. So this will let you change themes, colors, and fonts across your entire website. So for example, if I go to Site Header, click on Color, and I can change the color. Click Save, and back to my main page. Be sure to consult your assignment sheet and ask your instructor or professor if you have any questions about what to name your site, what content to put on your site, or how to organize your site. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you have a great semester.